You so smart? We give better deal. Pay us 200 shins or we kill you. No, I won't pay that. Then you die. Here we go, guys. We got to go first. Tie up here. We take out the leader first. Don't fight her unless we really have to. Actually, it doesn't look like we can fight her. Okay, good. Try not to catch her in any area affected stuff. Because we can give her to the decanted. +4.
Ooh, looks like that hurt.
Sucker punches abound. Wow. Just like that.
Some assistance is required.
Oh, she's hurting.
We've lost one palestige. And it's ours.
Now, I believe she gets up at the end of the fight, I think. Alright, let me get rid of this thing. Pack of molecular acid. Only one character? Now I think it has to wait. The next turn has to happen, I think. I don't have an action. Action already used. Here comes the other one. But we defeat these, we can let those guys go. There you go. But went behind the guy. Oh boy. I think I can raise Calistige? Yeah, I think so. It's been so long. Alright, what does he have? A mystic marble. Choose a position. I have a wisp now. Where's the wisp? This? I guess it's gonna appear next round. Can I move over here? Flank him?
Why not?
Yeah.
Surrounded on all sides.
Perfect. How about this? The arc. Look at that. Banquet! He's running out. Gonna have to rest soon. I think all of us. I I'm not sure. I got the Balefire. You know, I'm not sure if I have anything that could bring someone back. Choose an enemy.
What do you think of this?
Controlled. Now your friends are your enemies. Yay! I'm just gonna stay right here, actually. Nice!
Can't say I mind that.
Nah.
Alright, alright.
Do you mind that? He is hurting. He can also still attack? Awesome. Cool.
You never had a chance.
Is it controlled still? Well, let's flank this one then.
Something to do.
Oh, I'm stepping in the molecular stuff. Ugh. I thought I didn't realize it could hurt friends too. It makes sense that it can, but. I don't want to have her step there too, so. About some mental damage. Will that work? He's still controlled. Well, there's nobody else, so let's finish him off. Ah.
We must find a way to shake this off.
Glad to have you back with us, Calistige.
Alright.
Cool. Another spray flesh to replace the one we used in 40 shins. Three of these things now. Don't use it. No. I think I just drag it. Who needs a Calistige? Tiber. Yeah. Another one. Spray flash. 33 shins. Ditto. 26 shins. We're getting rich here. 20. We got so many of these spray flash things now. Another 20. Each one had loot. That's awesome. 24 shins. No.
Coming.
I want this. 87 shins, a fibrous bar. and a Murden Chief's key. Sweet! And 87 shin. We are rich. I gotta go shopping now. My god. 1749. Our poorness has righted itself. It's an oddity. Value is 400. This ancient key is fashioned of sin steel with a number of free-sliding blocks and spirals that move of their own volition. It is probably capable of opening one or more doors in the old slave block. You acquired the key from the Murden Chief, but it almost certainly dates back from a time long before the Murdens took residence in the old in the slave block. And we've got this thing, a fibrous bar. Plus 2 might pool. Plus 1 damage per effort applied, max plus 6 on esoteric attacks. Negative effects as minus 1 might edge. When placed under the tongue, this small metallic bar stings and burns the mouth. It also radiates a force that flows throughout the body, strengthening sinew and reinforcing muscle. Give it to Aratus, I guess? Oh, he's locked. You can only have one. Tiber doesn't have any. Cool. Got more might. We can give another to Tiber if we have any others. Bonded artifacts. That's an ornament. Yeah, that's mine. anything else? Yeah, I guess not. Maybe we saw the other stuff, we just haven't found that many. Alright. Murden's dead.
Sure enough.
Now we can let these guys go.
Absa-fraggin-loot.
Is it this guy who's the healthy one? Yeah, he's not doubled over. He nudges his companion, and both of them look at you with hope in their pain-filled eyes. Is the way clear? Did you get rid of the Murden guards at the entrance? So I guess I only had to kill the two at the entrance. Oh, I killed them all. It's worth it, though. We got so many of those frickin' spray flesh things. It's awesome. If you go hide in the next cell. It's clear. You should be able to make your way to safety.
I'll remember that.
Gold tide, moderate. Have our gratitude, friend. Farewell. We'll tell Brusca about you. I doubt those guards will make it home alive. Not if they rely on strangers to help them. Well,
of course.
I'm a safe stranger for them anyway. Well, the Murdens are done for.
Action! Here I come.
Unless there's some others out hunting, I'm pretty sure they just stay down here. So we have a few quests to do. We can go see Demaray and Obervich about what's her name's site. We can go back to Brusca. We need to rest. We all need to rest this time. So let's go rest first.
Gladly,
and gladly rest. Cost us, but we can afford it. Yay!
I can stand a little more of that.
You're fine. You're full now. Nice. Well, I suppose this guy will talk to us, Ragman. He didn't before. Got nothing to talk about. Alright.
Go.
Alright, so here is Church and Slump.
Alright.
Go talk to the good doctors. See if they want to restore that crazy faceless lady's sight. And she's missing every other organ on her face. I guess sight is the most precious to her. At last we meet. For the first time, for the last time. Hail. Ah, friend, welcome back. Demaray wipes his nose and grabs your hand, pumping it furiously. Obovich says, oh, you returned. I hope something is wrong with you. By which I mean I hope that we get to treat you. By which I mean, of course, that you are fascinating. Just fascinating. Do you know of any way to restore the sight of someone without eyes? Without eyes? Were they destroyed, or is this inherited? Was this a creature that has no visual cortex? He waves his hands. It makes no matter. I can restore sight to any living creature. He leans forward and taps your chest. Any. He thinks we restore the blessing of sight, and with just a few minor side effects. Obovich is nodding and smiling, and prepares to offer a boast himself, but as he holds up his strange arm, his index fingers in the air, he pauses and says quietly, do you mean restoring sight and retaining independent nervous autonomy? That is, without scooping out portions of the brain? The subject should retain her faculties, yes. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. He paces a very small circle. I know only one procedure that meets the specific qualification that she retain all her faculties, I'm afraid. It is long work. Long, hard work. Long, hard, expensive work. He glances at Obovich. He thinks one of Obovich's eyes should do it, but this cast-off, we cannot pass up this opportunity. The half-man returns his partner's quick look. It would require compensation worth more than coin. Perhaps if you found us an interesting test subject for investigation, we could consider a fair trade. And when I say perhaps and could, I actually mean that it would suffice. He thinks, I see where Dr. Demaray is headed with this. She would make an excellent test subject. What qualifications do you need for an interesting test subject? Demaray says, all of our patients are unique in some way. We need someone outside the norm, someone who has some special aspect that no one else can offer. He thinks, someone nigh immortal, perhaps. Obovich says, oh, yes, yes. We are always trying to expand our knowledge, advance the field of study to, well, you get the point. We need someone who can help us develop art and understanding, which is to say, someone new, not someone we've already enhanced. Someone outside the norm with some aspect no one else could deliver. And, I hasten to ask, someone whom we've not yet enhanced. Obovich looks at his partner and chuckles. We can hardly learn from our own genius now, can we? Expensive and time-consuming? What about all the eyes your colleague has on his head? Did he undergo all those surgeries, one by one? Obovich says, my friend, these eyes provide a valuable function for me, and they are not simple baubles to be handed out as favors. They are affixed to me, and provide certain insights. He bobs his head quickly and nervously, as if to belie his words. One of them falls from his head. Blast, he adds, hastily scooping it up and reattaching it. Demaray says, very well, very well. You've caught us in a slight embellishment, as one might expect from someone of your mental caliber. He looks to his compatriot. Did I not tell you that our friend's intellect was something to be admired? I did. He bows to you. We don't necessarily need a subject, I suppose, but I did not embroider the truth entire. This is an expensive item. To replace it will cost us 280 shins. Would any of my companions serve as an adequate test subject? Ahem. Well, let me be perfectly frank, since my broad hints were apparently a little too subtle. I was hoping that you might let us examine you. Now, my friend, Obervik says, let us not be greedy or presumptuous. We have been presented with an intriguing choice. Let us examine this opportunity with the thoroughness it deserves.
I'll remember that.
Demaray reaches for Aratus. A pale boy? No, I don't think... Wait a moment. This golden cloud, do you know what it does, lad? Are you aware of... He stops talking, aware that Aratus is simply staring at him. This boy will be an excellent subject. He thinks, is it chemical, transdimensional, or nanitical? It doesn't matter. Oervik says, aye, yes. We've already had some exposure to our former colleague, Callistes. We've had our researches and our hypotheses, and so far have turned up nothing. We'd love the chance to expand our knowledge. Oervik lifts his eyes to Tybear. A sellsword past his prime? Does he do any tricks? Have any hidden talents? Does he perhaps gout purple flame from his rear? Obervik's eyes click through a number of different foci and filters, and he frowns. No, just an ordinary man. No, not suitable. If you can convince your companion to submit to our ministrations, we are ready to begin any time you are. Can we ask them? Can we ask Callistes if she wants to? Aratus?
What's on your mind?
I spoke with the nano-spirits inside you. Do you feel any different? My ideas don't feel as shouty as they used to, he says, thinking hard. But other than that, no. You sure? I think I'm still me. And that me hasn't changed. Though naturally we prefer the interesting tusk subject, a bit of coin is always welcome. His eyes fix on the glowing cloud that surrounds Aratus. The boy will be an ideal subject, oh yes. We will gladly examine him if he agrees to the procedure. If she permits us to examine her further, we would be delighted to work with our colleague Callistes again. Well, maybe they can help Aratus? You said Aratus would be an acceptable choice. Aratus, the woman with no face needs our help. His opinion of you have worsened, huh? Gold tied, though. Moderate. Having no face makes her seem more like a monster than someone we should help. But no, a hero helps everyone. Very well. Puffing up his chest, he happily steps to the table where Demaray and Obervich await. I am not afraid. Study me all you like, as long as it doesn't hurt, and you don't poke at my teeth. I don't like that. A thought strikes him. Do you think you could put hands on my feet? Could that happen? Those nanite things inside him think, we are not sure this is a good idea. We sense suffering ahead for him or us. I suppose it could happen, but I make no promises. The doctors make encouraging noises to Aratus, soothing sounds that calm his nerves, as they lead him away. Demaray pulls a white curtain around them. A high-pitched buzzing emanates from the operating area, and then a strong golden pulse, like a heartbeat, fills the small room. Hours pass, and the glow dims. At last, Demaray steps out to greet you. Behind him, you see Aratus sitting on a long table. The glow around Aratus is patchy and flaking, rather than a robust shine. He looks drained. Demaray's dirty coat is slightly dirtier than before, and a sheen of sweat covers his forehead. His eyes are aglow, however. Fantastic! Just then, fantastic! Your cohort was an excellent subject. We hardly dug around inside him at all, so he should recover quickly. Oh my, yes. We've studied patients number 8 through... That's a huge number. That's 28 to the 7th power, and we'll be able to file them under number 28 for easier reference. But lost track of the patients because they kept co-joining and separating. Your friend performs splendidly. I don't know what that means. I hope you don't mind, but we took a small sample to investigate more thoroughly. At any rate, I'm sure you want to be off. He stands expectantly, waiting for you to leave. Tell me what you learned about Aratus. Well, your friend here is not what he seems, at least not entirely. The glow that surrounds him is a collective machine intelligence, and the cloud draws its strength from him even as it makes him stronger and more skillful. At the current rate of energy transfer, he's not likely to survive much longer, but that remaining time will be amazing. More study of our sample will be warranted, of course. He inclines his head towards the exit, clearly offering a hint. Aratus seems a bit out of sorts and can't seem to focus. His field is fluctuating wildly, almost panicked, as although he himself seems calm, almost blank. What am I doing here? Who are you? He blinks. Who am I? A note of fear enters his voice. What is that buzzing? Am I dreaming? The whatever's inside him thing. Error, error. Connections lost, connections burning. He'll be fine in no time. Back to normal. Normal in no time at all. You'll see. Now, if that concludes our business. So, what do we do about my blind acquaintance? I'm eager to look and see if he's, damaged. What? Oh, yes. My apologies. He reaches up to the profusion of eyes on his head and selects one, seemingly at random. With a grimace, he works it free from his head. His scarred flesh flows around and fills the hole where it resided. Simply place this eye in the recipient's face and it will do the rest of the work. Easy. What if I put it on my own face? It will likely not work. Blue tide. And it would scoop out a portion of your brain in the attempt. No, sadly, I cannot recommend that you try it. Farewell. Good day. My god, guys. Oh, here it is. Obervich's eye. Obervich plucked this eye from the multitude of eyes on his head and gave it to you so that you might restore sight to Skoura. He promises it will work simply by placing it on her face. The artificial eye is so well constructed that it could pass as a real eye on cursory inspection. Okay. Aratus. Aratus. I wonder what changed with him. It's not like I have all the stats memorized.
What's on your mind?
So, we've... gone with him up one and then down one, I think. He still likes the last cast off, so I guess he revered me once I helped him, and I was back down to like, because I volunteered him. I mean, all I did was ask. He could have refused, right? So we need to go back. I need to go back and help her. So these are going to be slightly longer episodes. What I want to do is I want to tie up two of these quests, and then episode 100 will be a little Nihilish. So back to the old slave block to help what's her name?
On it.
Faceless woman. And we'll get that artifact. But of course. Her head tilts at your footfalls, and her lips smack as she scents the air.
Why do you return? What have you brought this poor Skoura?
You think she returns? Few have done so. Maybe... No. Best not to get my hopes up. I have an eye for you. Press Oberfish's eye into her face.
Sweet sight returns? I welcome it, friend.
The eye begins to burn into her flesh, extruding small legs that heat and twist as they burrow deeper into the meat and bone of her head. God, man. She claps her hands over the eye, instinctively scrabbling at the invasive device, and you recognize the titanic act of will it takes for her to let the eye do its work. Her trust in you must be great, or her need for vision desperate.
So much pain, yet nothing compared to how I lost them. Did she speak true?
Cold tide, moderate. Oh, I didn't get to look. Did I look at that? Yeah, I did look at it. After what seems like an eternity of her screams and moans, Skoura pulls her hands from her disfigured face. She tilts her head up at you, and her mouth stretches into an involuntary smile of pure joy. You wave your hand in front of her face, and the eye tracks it naturally, cleanly. She throws her arms around you, sobbing with relief and happiness.
I see! The lights, the shadows, the bloom! Never has this meat hell looked so wonderful!
At last she collects herself, wiping away the stream of tears that poured from the single eye. She looks in amazement at the moisture on her hands and mutters,
It has rebuilt the entire structure! Amazing! More investigation required!
Then she glances up at you and thrusts a jar into your hands.
Here, more trouble than it was worth.
She turns away, gasping in delight at every newly revealed sight. Jar of Iron Wind, quest item artifact. Made from opaque battered metal, this jar looks like a repurposed cylinder. Just above its surface, a control panel is projected into the air, displaying enigmatic diagrams and text that indicate the status of its contents. The jar thrums with energy, seeming almost alive. According to Skoura, the nano who gave you this jar, it contains a small part of the Iron Wind, dangerous nano-spirits that warp and transform any matter they touch. Wow.
I think I'm ready to try something new.
Who knew the bloom held such wonders? The world is beautiful, friend. Even this day, forsaken place.
I freed the patrol that was being held captive in the old slave block, and they fled to safety. Alright, so that's our next thing to do. And we can level Tyvir. Level Tyvir. Edge. He doesn't have edge and might.
Learned a thing or two.
He has a shoot first ability. Gain plus 30% on attacks against enemies with a lower initiative than Tyvir. The ninth world is full of the graves of honorable men, and Tyvir has no intention of joining them. His attacks do much more damage against unprepared opponents. Sweet. We have abilities, resourceful. Plus one training level. Yeah, more ciphers. Versatile effort. 5% bonus for each level of effort applied to tasks it affects. Virtuoso. Max effort plus one on all non-combat tasks. And limits of human capacity. Gain 20... Oh, 2 might, 2 speed, total intellect. Gain plus 25% movement speed, plus 5 initiative, plus 1 max effort, plus 15% on all tasks. Sweet. You know how to make the most of your body and how to summon your deepest reserves. You can push yourself harder and longer than any but the most elite athletes. Yeah, this one. Quick fingers. Running. I'll do that. Sweet. Alright. Yeah, so not only the 100 is a special episode, but these are special too, because I'm going to be splitting 3 episodes among 2 hours. That's like 45 minutes each. We'll see how long Preska takes. So we'll get to wrap up that quest. Oop. Flicker there. Oh my god, what's that? I thought we were gonna crash there. No crashy crash. Back again, lovely. Buska, hail. You found your men. I rescued 2 of your men in the old slave block. Preska raises an eyebrow. So you're the one? Yes, you match the description Aiken gave me. He stumbled back here a while ago. Zebak nearly unconscious on his shoulder. She nods. Thank you. Here, take this. It's not much, but I owe you something. 140 shins. So there's more patrols. Somewhere in the vast interior, or maybe one of the slums. We got some money. Without a doubt, we got money. Skady have some armor and stuff. Mmm, that looks sweet. She has a sting charge. Liquid death. Yeah, I don't see anything. Sting charge is the best. Heavy crossbow is good too, but I don't think she can use heavy weapons. He's using a healing sword. Oh wait, what about the slug spinner? It's not even that much money. Hold on. She has inability in medium and heavy weapons. Alright. I mean, she might have some ciphers and stuff we can use, but I have so many right now. Maybe there'll be someone selling some awesome things in Little Nylash. Possibly. Still try to click on the map now and time again to select. like in other games, like Pillars of Eternity and such. But it doesn't work that way.
To action!
Gotta find that. Orving. Might be a little Nylash. This is at some point. The Maw. Oh wait, decanted. You know what? I'll do... I killed all those crows, but we didn't kill the... Yeah. She may be of interest. Yeah, I'm gonna go back and do that after this. Forgot. Missing patrols. Oh. If Murden stole the frame, they would have hidden it somewhere in their lair. I doubt it'll be easy to find. Huh, hidden? We'll have to go back there at some point. And the thugs. Delny and Vrung are hiding in Little Nylash as well, so... Thanks so much for watching, guys. We will take care of a couple of these quests in Little Nylash when we return. And see you in the next one, guys. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.